Good morning, children. Hoping you all are safe at home. So, children, today we'll be reading a new chapter, and that is chapter number 4 of your EBS book, that is Food We Eat. Okay, children? So, children, food we eat. Before starting the chapter, I'd like to ask you a few questions, children. Food. We all are eating food, right, children? So, can you leave without eating? No. We cannot leave. So why food is so much required for all of us? Because to live and to grow. So moving on to the chapter, children. We need food to live and to grow. As I already said to you, that we need food to live and to grow. It makes us healthy and strong. So by eating food only, we are healthy and we are strong enough. Food gives us energy to walk and to play. Whatever food we are eating, it gives us energy to walk, whatever work we are doing, and also to play. We get all our food from plants and animals. So whatever food we are eating is coming either from the plants or from the animals. Now, children, a few examples I'll give you. So food from plants, we have already discussed in our June classes. So food that we are getting from the plants are, we can say spices, then vegetables, fruits, nuts, oil, this all things, grains are coming from plants. Then food we get from animals, that is milk, then meat, eggs, seafood, fish, this all are food from animals. Okay, so grains, that was a food that we get from the plants. So it was grains. So now, children, what are grains? Grain means they are some dry sheets. Okay, so barley, maize, oats, rice, wheat, all these are grains. Children, a grains is a new thing for you, so I'll just write it. Grains are barley. I'll show you in the PowerPoint presentation also after the class gets over. Wheat, rice, maize. At least 4 you can remember, okay? Then, cardamom, cumin, coriander, pepper, and turmeric are some spices. Spices means, children, masala. So they add flavor and color to our food. Because of the spices only, our food are having flavor. Flavor means taste. Taste and color is also coming to our food. So spices, as I told you, that they are the masalas. So you can write, you can know that spices means cardamom, cumin. There are many more spices, children, but in your book only these are there. Then pepper, at least 4 you remember, turmeric. Okay, so as I said, your spices add flavor and color to our food. Then moving on to food groups. See, children, whatever food we are eating, it belongs to some other groups. So there are basically 3 type of food groups. So before starting the food groups, I'll tell you another thing, that is, our diet is the food we eat and drink regularly. Diet. It's a new word for you, that is diet. D-I-E-T. See, children, diet means what? Whatever food we are eating and whatever water we are drinking regularly. Okay, that is the diet. Then a balanced diet. Another new word for you. It's balanced diet. So balanced diet means is the right amount of food from each food group. Means right amount, whatever food we are consuming, it should be of right amount from each food group. There are different type of food groups, as I said you. So from each food groups, right amount we should eat or we should consume. Okay, it helps us to remain healthy. So if we are continuing to eat in a balanced diet, then only we can remain healthy. See, children, if you people love to have pizza, so if every time in breakfast, in lunch, in dinner, you will continuously have pizza, then obviously you will fall sick. So there should be, if you want to have pizza, at least in a week once you can have it. That won't make you fall sick. So that is very important to know that which food and up to which amount you should consume to remain healthy. Okay, so now, children, as I said you, there are different food groups. So starting with energy giving food. energy giving means any food that is giving us energy. Yes. So we need energy for everything we do. Whatever work we are doing, for that we need energy. So food that gives us energy is called energy giving food. So whatever food that is giving us energy to do our work is energy giving food. So few examples are there, like rice. Yes, we have it in lunch daily. So rice is a energy giving food. Potato, sugar and butter. So this four are your energy giving food. Rice, potato, sugar, butter. Okay, these foods are having a lot of energy, and by eating this we get energy. So these are named as energy giving food. Now moving on to the next one, that is bodybuilding food. Again the name says it all, children. Bodybuilding. Yes, we have a body, and to build it means to grow, we consume bodybuilding food. Okay. So food that helps our bones and muscles to grow strong is called bodybuilding food. So whatever food we are eating and that is helping us to grow our bones, our muscles, to make it strong, that is bodybuilding food. So examples can be grains, peas, pulses, milk, eggs and meat are bodybuilding food. Okay, any four you remember, because many are there, the easy ones we'll remember, that is peas, then grains, eggs, meat, pulses means dals. Okay, these all are and bodybuilding food. Then the last one, that is protective food. Protective food. Now children, this name is a different one. See, protective food means something that is, some food that is protecting us. Yes, but from what it is protecting us? It is protecting us from the diseases. So it is named as protective food. So food that protects us from diseases and helps us to remain healthy. So because we are not suffering from any diseases, it is helping us to remain healthy. So this food are protective food. And all fruits and some vegetables are eaten raw. So best example of protective food are vegetables and fruits. So it is always said by your parents to have fruits and vegetables, so that you won't be sick, you will be protected from diseases. Okay, so and all the fruits we eat raw, but some vegetables can be eaten raw. All the vegetables cannot be eaten. So some vegetables are cooked to make them soft and tasty. So some vegetables we cook them because they are so hard we cannot eat them, so we cook them to make it soft and tasty. So example I have already written, all the vegetables and fruits are protective food. So these are the three type of food. Next, vegetarian and non-vegetarian. Okay, I think you all have heard about these words, vegetarian and non-vegetarians. So a vegetarian eat food only from plants and also milk and milk products. Okay, so a vegetarian means a person who is only having plant products or from plants, any food that is coming from the plants, and milk also, and milk products also. Milk products means cheese, curd, butter, ghee. This thing, when a person is having, he is known as a vegetarian. And a person who eats eggs, seafood, meat is a non-vegetarian. And a person who is consuming or eating meat, egg, seafood, as I already said you, seafood means prawn, fish, crabs, lobsters, this all are seafood. And also he is taking milk and milk products also, and also food that is coming from the plants. He is a non-vegetarian. So vegetarian means he is not consuming this egg, meat, seafood. He is not having it. Okay. So vegetarian, non-vegetarian. Then meals. See children, we know that meals, all of you have must heard about this word, that is meal. Meal. So meal means is the food we eat. What whatever food we are eating is a meal. At one time, what food we are eating, it is a meal. We usually eat meals with family or friends. Yes, whenever we are eating meals, we eat with the family or friends. Just a minute, children. Let me rub the board. See, children. Meals basically are of three types: breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So, breakfast, lunch, and dinner are the three main meals. These are the three main meals. Okay. So, we have breakfast, yes, in the morning. In the afternoon and dinner at night. Okay? So, meal means the food that we eat. So, another new word again, that is brunch. B-R-U-N-C-H. Brunch. See, brunch means is a meal that we eat late in the morning in the place of breakfast and lunch. For example, you have skipped your breakfast in the morning. So, if you are hungry and you cannot wait for the lunch time, so in the middle of, means in the morning hours only, you are having, not very early morning, but in the morning hours only, you are having your brunch. Okay, the food that you are having is a brunch. Means you are having it in the place of breakfast and lunch. That is known as brunch. Okay, then water. Our body needs a lot of water. Yes, children, I know you all are drinking a lot of water. That is very important for our body. Water helps us to digest our food. Whatever food we are eating, to digest it, we need water. It flushes waste out of our body. Whatever waste we are having inside our body, because of the water only, it is coming outside. Therefore, we should drink at least 6 to 8 glasses of water every day. I know you people must be drinking that much of water. If not, then please go with that. 6 to 8 glasses of water every day we should drink. We should always drink boiled or filtered water. Okay? Boiled, either boiling water or filtered water we should have. We can fall sick if we drink dirty water. If you are drinking dirty water from any place, you may fall sick. Jaundice and typhoid are two common diseases caused by dirty water. So, jaundice and typhoid are the two common diseases that is caused by drinking dirty water. Now, children, I'll tell you some golden food habits. What food habits you should have, and that is golden. It's very, very important and interesting too. So, first thing is, do not eat stale or uncovered food. Stale means no longer fresh. It's not fresh. Okay, you should not have that. Or any food, if it is not covered, that also you should not eat. Do not eat from roadside shops. If some shops are there in the roads, you should not eat from that place also, because germs may be there. Okay, do not waste food and water. You should not waste your food and water. It is very precious. Eat meals at regular intervals. It's not that you are hungry so all the time you will be eating. No, you have to have some intervals to have your food. Meet some time limit. Do not overeat. If you suppose you love pizza, so because you love pizza, so you will eat the whole one. It is not good. Whatever you should consume, you should have that much only. You should not overeat. Wash hands before and after meals. This is very important, children. Before having any of your meals, wash your hands before also and after eating also. Rinse your mouth after eating. After eating, you have to rinse your mouth. Rinse your mouth means wash your mouth with water. Okay, so that it will, if the germs are inside your mouth, it will be washed up. Then, do not eat too much of fats and sweets. If you see, children, I know you people love chocolates. So, you should not, because you love chocolate, you should not have a lot of chocolates. Again, you will fall sick. So, you should not overeat. do not eat in a hurry, chew your food properly. And you should not eat in a hurry. You have to chew your food properly and eat it. Okay, children, this was the chapter. I know no more doubts. If any doubts, children, you can call me. But before ending, I'll show you some of the pictures. Okay, children? Okay. Okay, children, see. These are some of the food from plants. That is fruits, cereals, that are the grains, oil, vegetables, spices and pulses. Okay? Then food from animals. As I said you, meat, chicken, fish, cheese, honey. Okay? Seafood. These all are the food that we get from animals. Energy giving food. So, rice, butter, sugar, potato. Okay, these all are energy giving food. Then bodybuilding food. Peas, milk, pulses and egg, meat. These all are bodybuilding food. Then protective food. That is vegetables. See, all many type of vegetables are there. And fruits. Here also so many type of fruits are there. So all the vegetables and fruits are protective food. Then as I said, you three main meals. That is breakfast, lunch, dinner. So breakfast, anything you can have. I have given you some pictures. Then lunch and dinner. Okay. Then grains. As I said, you it was a new term for you. Grains. See children, barley. Okay. Oats, corn, rice, wheat. These are grains. Then spices. See, turmeric is haldi. Okay. Then what was cinnamon. Okay. Then black pepper, cardamom, mustard seeds. This all are available at your homes. You can see it. Okay children, these are spices. Okay children, I know you all have must understood the chapter. Still children, if any queries, you can contact me. Okay children, take care. Bye children.